I've said this on plenty of live streams, but never on a video. Sometimes the nicest thing a teacher can do for a student is let them come in, lay their head down, and go to sleep. And here's a perfect example. I've got a student who came into class today and he was visibly upset. You could tell something was wrong, but it was early in the morning. Maybe he just hadn't had his coffee. So almost as soon as class starts, his buddy comes up to me and says, "Hey, be easy on this guy today. His grandfather died last night." My first thought is, why is he even here today? But my second thought is, he's here, so what can I do about it? I know I'm not going to call him out, and I know I'm not going to say anything in front of the whole class, but here's what I do. So we were taking a really big test. I passed them out to all the students, and everybody's got theirs, and then I go back to my desk, and I write a little post-it note. I walk it over to this guy, and I stick it to his test, and it basically just says, "I'm sorry for your loss. I'm praying for you. You already have a 100 on this test. Don't even worry about it. Just turn it in." I don't say that to brag, and I don't say that to build myself up. I say that because sometimes as teachers, our tests are not as important as a student's personal life, and we all need to recognize that, students and teachers both.
What?
What noise is that? Are you done?
No.
Do a different TikTok trend. Ding, 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 ding. Ding, ding, ding.
My shoulder's cold. I've got to leave here before I go. I pull my shirt on, walk out the door. Drag my feet along the floor. I pull my shirt on, walk out the door. Drag my feet along the floor. Then I see you. You're walking across the campus. Cool professor studying romance.
So, can anyone tell me what the author might have meant in this paragraph? Alyssa. Okay. Well, not quite. Okay, not quite. You're on the right track, all right? This is the right track, and this is you. You're on the right track, but not quite, all right? Maybe we should look at it from another perspective. Jason. I don't think that's really it. You're getting warmer. Okay, warmer. Let's try to look at it this way. So
I found this breakup letter while you guys were at PE, and we haven't really talked about letters in this class, but like, we're not allowed to pass notes. Like, you're fifth graders, you know that. So I was wondering if you want me to read it.
Yeah.
Let's see. I've already read it. So I don't know who it's from. We'll see. They wrote a lot.
Oh my God.
This is some tea. I'm not sure how to start this letter, but I feel like we need to talk. I've been thinking about us a lot lately, and it's just not working. I've thought we would be together forever, but things are starting to change. Now here's the reasons they're breaking up. One, you never ask what I want before you make decisions. You don't care how I feel about the mean things you do. You're also way too controlling. You never let me have any freedom when I want to do my own thing. You make me pay for things I shouldn't have to pay for. It's ridiculous how much money I'm spending on you. My favorite part? And you let your friends stay at my house without even asking me.
What?
Hashtag rude. I'm not trying to hurt you, but I need some time by myself to see what it's like on my own. I just really need some freedom. I'm officially breaking up with you. Sorry, not sorry. Love no more. The American colonists.
What? You freaked out. This is not right.
Hi friends, this is my fiance, Mr. Jake. He's gonna be in our workout today. We're gonna be starting off with 10 jumping jacks, okay? Ready? Patrick, you better be doing these, you piece of shit, or I'm gonna call your mom. You need to start participating. Let's go. Nice job, Billy. All right, I lost count. I think that's 10. Okay, now we can stretch our arms. Just arm across your chest. Levi, are you deaf, blind, or just a moron? Let's go.
Jesus Christ.
Arm across chest, guys. We're gonna do our legs next. Morgan, put your ratty ass hair up in a ponytail so you can see. Come on, girl. And three.
Maybe you don't have good sense because you're sitting here arguing with me and you're making me mad, and I'm gonna send you to the office if you don't shut up! That does it.
Most of us are here, so if you want to pull out your Journeys book.
What was that?
What?
I think she farted. That was a big one.
What are you singing?
Running game song.
Oh my gosh, that's my favorite.
Renegade.
Where'd you learn the renegade from?
You.
From me?
Yeah. Mommy said you had, you're on the TV and then you're doing TikTok.
What?
He showed me your TikToks you did.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
I've been knowing that.
Come on, let's link.
And do what I do, watch me up and all hands.
Hey.
Like monarchy, we slide that touch.
What you know about love?
About what you need.
Welcome to
the
story,
get
you
on.
You can share what you please. We've had it
all. Hey. Chicken wing, chicken wing.
Hot dog and bologna, chicken and macaroni, chilling with my homies, chicken wing.
Little mama, party girl.
She just wanna fun too. She's in you and wife me, but I don't care, I want you.
Yo, mans. Y'all don't let me sing no song. I bet y'all know this one. Through the window.
To the wall.
Oh, Victor. Y'all don't know this one, though.
Which one?
Baby.
Baby. Baby. Oh, my baby. Baby. Baby.
That wasn't even.
I'm bringing sexy back. Yeah. The mother don't know how to act. Yeah. Go let me make up for the things you lack. Yeah. Cause you're burning up, I gotta get it fast.
Which one? What's the longest river in the world? What's the longest river in the world? It's asking what year the Louisiana Purchase was. What year? What's the largest and deepest ocean? What's an ocean? Now, which one is the largest and deepest? Think about that. Which one do you think it is? Try it out. Need help? Raise your hand. Question. I cannot help you. This is a test. You just finished a 30-minute test in 5 minutes. You need to check your answers.
Ranking my students' asynchronous Friday check-ins, part two. Okay, so just like last time, they didn't have a real assignment. All they had to do was go in and say, good morning, hello, how you doing, hi, anything like that. The first category we're gonna look at are the sincere ones, like this one. Good morning, Mr. Maynard, hope you're having a great day, and I hope you have a great spring break. Or this one, greetings, Senor Maynard, wish you the best of the weekend and spring break. Or this one, good morning, have a wonderful spring break. My favorite of the sincere ones is this. Greetings, O dear teacher of mine. How doth thou sun rise and fall so effortlessly? I shall see thee once again on the morrow of the 12th of April. The next category is bilingual greetings. So I got Samoan, Hebrew, Greek, Russian, Japanese, and Chinese. This one means, hello, I'm very tired today. I want coffee. Happy weekend. Okay, now onto the weird ones. I got the lyrics from Driver's License, the script to the first Shrek movie. Actually, I got that twice. This kid just wrote poop. Bananas, B-A-N-A-N-A-N, and the Arby's 2-for-6 menu. I love them all. 10 out of 10.
You're going to be suspended from school for 4 days.
Okay.
I want you to call your parents, tell them what you've done.
Hi, Mom.
Tyler? Whose phone is this?
Principal Jacobson's.
I'm listening.
I punched a kid in the face.
You did what?
But he said I was a-
I don't care what he said! They go low, you go high. I did not raise a monster. I am so disappointed in you. Here's your father.
Ty, what happened?
This kid said I was fat. And then I would be a loser the rest of my life, so I beat the shit out of him.
Let's go. Good job, son. What did I always tell you? If someone messes with you, you fight back. That kid is never gonna bully you again. Way to stand up for yourself. Proud of you, son.
Thanks, Dad.
All right, listen close. I'm gonna yell at you right now because I want your mother to think I'm pissed, okay?
Okay.
Punched him in the face! Are you kidding me? Who do you think you are, Mike Tyson? You're gonna come home to Mike Tyson. I'm gonna shove your PS5 controller so far up your ass, your nipples are gonna be the freaking analog sticks!
What's your question? No, no, you cannot use the restroom during a test. You know this. What happens if you take that 4 and move it right here? Tyler. Mackenzie, eyes on your own paper. Guys, we talked about number 4 yesterday, if you were listening. What are you writing? Lowest denominator. Shh, let him sleep. Did you bring a snack? Shh. You okay? It's okay, you can turn in your homework tomorrow morning. Mind your business, I told her she could leave early. If it's not B or C, then what does that leave? Have a great weekend. Mac, come here. How are you? I don't care that it's not all done. You did your best, right? That's all that matters. Okay, but if they pick on you again, you come get me.
Everybody go around the circle and say your name and a cool fun fact about yourself. We'll start over here. Jake, if you don't stop right now, I'm literally gonna fight you and you know I will. Hi everybody, my name is Jocelyn, but you probably already knew that. I play 18 sports and I hate girls that wear makeup. Hey everybody, my name's Oliver, but you can call me Mr. Nice Guy. My fun fact about myself is that I'm very ugly. Okay, does anyone want to tell me that I'm wrong? Hey, my name's Addison, but not like Addison Rae because I'm not on straight TikTok. What else am I supposed to say? Not me forgetting everything, what? Oh my God, you guys have been staring at me like this whole time, stop. Anyway, my name's Violet. Fun fact about myself is I like to record myself dancing in the rain. Hey guys, my name is Pineapple. I'm just kidding. My name's Emily. A fun fact about myself is I love pizza and I'm kind of a crackhead. Guys, don't worry. It's just a knee brace. Dylan, did you see what happened? No, I'm fine. I'm tough. I just hurt it playing basketball, football, soccer, and volleyball. Like, sucks that I have to wear it over my jeans so everyone can see. Like, I wish I could wear it, like, under a dress like you, but, like, I hate dresses and they're ugly. I mean, what's your biggest injury? Like, breaking a nail? I play 17 sports. And I know you go to all my games and stuff because you're, like, obsessed with me, but I'm not going to be able to play tonight. It's not like I'm going to go and cheer for the team. Like, cheerleading's not a sport, so.
I'm going to run to the bathroom.
Yeah, I do.
Run around.
Why did we all have that one teacher who dressed like this in middle school?
Things my students do that I just don't get. Part 5.
Morning, Mrs. Woolley. Can I eat this candy?
It's 8 in the morning.
So?
Why don't you just bring it to lunch?
Oh, fine.
Okay, guys, did everyone get a paper?
Yep.
Yep. Where's your test?
Oh, I didn't get one.
Mrs. Woolley, I can't open my locker.
Something is stuck and is preventing my locker from closing. I know. Perfect.
Can I go fill up my water bottle in the hall?